The best cookie dough oatmeal that only takes 2 minutes to cook. To start, add a half cup of oats to a bowl, then a half cup of almond milk. Next, I add 1 tablespoon of almond butter and then 2 to 3 teaspoons of maple syrup. Microwave this on high for 1 minute, stir and repeat. It should come out looking like this. I give it a quick stir and then finally I add some dark chocolate chips on top. And there you go, cookie dough oatmeal in under 5 minutes.
Started the day with warm lemon water, granola with oat milk and cashew butter for breakfast, a Lara bar for a snack. I try to drink 2 of these a day, a Mediterranean bowl for lunch, almonds for another snack, curry with coconut rice and a sweet potato for dinner, and my sister made brownies for dessert.
I pull up, step in the kitchen, let's go. Brand new Lamborghini, a cop car, with a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop. Have you ever met a real new rock star? This ain't no guitar.
Easy pancake time. Grab 1 ripe banana, 2 eggs, and mush it all up. Then turn your heat to medium low, spray your pan, and dollop a spoonful of the batter onto the pan. Once it's a little firm, flip it. This makes about 7 pancakes. They're super easy and so healthy for you. Let's taste it. Oh my gosh, so good, I'm dancing.
First we're gonna toast some bread, avocado, mash and spread. Cut the tomatoes, put them face down, crumble feta all around. Boil some water with white wine vinegar, you'll be ready for the poached egg finisher. Wait 3 minutes and scoop it out, put it in the middle just about. Take a picture where it's sunny, show your yolk is nice and runny. Now on social you can boast, you made avocado toast.
Imagine if Taco Bell made a Crunchwrap with Doritos. It would probably be the best thing on their menu, so let's make it at home and even better. The full tutorial just went up on my YouTube and the link is in my bio. It would mean so much if you checked it out, and I hope you enjoy.
Pot roast is so tender and juicy, but has a secret ingredient I know will have some of y'all bugging. My grand aunt gave me her sorority's cookbook, and in it was a Coca-Cola pot roast, so I had to recreate my own version. I used only salt and pepper on the roast like the original recipe, but for the seasoning police, you can add as many different seasonings as you want. In a large pan, sear your roast on all sides, add some onions, celery, rosemary, thyme, and carrots. The full recipe can be found on my website, thereisfoodathome.com. Add 2.5 cups of cola. It won't taste like cola. It just tenderizes the meat. Google it. For more flavor, add 1 packet of French onion soup and enough water to almost cover the pot roast. Bring to a boil, turn down the heat, and let simmer for 2.5 hours. Add in some potatoes and let simmer for an additional 30 minutes. By now, it should be juicy and tender. I love making pot roasts because they're pretty easy and hands-off. I told y'all there's food at home.
Do you know how fucking hard it is to keep a healthy diet when your sister is constantly cooking and 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 cooking? I swear to God, I will hire her as my private chef when I get married.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Okay, let me put you on real quick, because everyone I put this on to never orders a McFlurry the way they ordered it before they knew this. Order an Oreo McFlurry with fudge on top and caramel on the bottom and watch it change your life.
Guys, my name's Jill and I'm broke. So what I do is I sell these desserts at my school, and this week I decided to sell some German chocolate cake, and this is how I made it. So I started off by making these three layers of chocolate cake, and then I popped those babies in the oven. I set my timer and I took them out with my bare hands. And then it became so late that I watched it turn into 2 a.m. I know, crazy. Then the next morning I leveled off some of my cakes, I ate some of the cake scraps, and then I made this coconut caramel, which I then added more coconut to, so it became this like German chocolate filling, you know? Then I made some chocolate ganache, and I stacked all those things up in my cake. But let me just tell you, frosting this cake was a nightmare, okay? It's impossible to get coconut smooth, so it kind of looked ugly, but whatever, I'll get over it. Then I added some of these chocolate cake crumbs to the side, and then I somehow accomplished the incredible feat of moving this cake successfully to the cake stand. I know, crazy. Then I added some of these chocolate ganache decorations, then I cut it up and I ate it, and then I sold the rest to my friends. So thanks guys for buying my cake. Anyway, I'll see you guys later, bye.
New York Bagel Reviews Part 5, Tompkins Square Bagels. Every time I post a bagel review, I get so many comments telling me to go to Tompkins Square, so here I am. First glance, absolutely loved the look of the bagel. It was crisp on the outside and fluffy on the inside. The bacon, egg, and cheese was good, but my favorite part was definitely the bagel. It was light and so delicious. I also got this really cute cold brew. Highly recommend this place.
Does anybody else have that snack that they invented when they were younger and it was absolutely delicious and you were super, super proud of it and you made it for everyone, you ate it all the time, you even took pictures of it? Yeah? Okay, so this is mine.
Do you know how fucking hard it is to keep a healthy diet when your sister is constantly cooking and 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 cooking? I swear to God I will hire her as my private chef when...
Look, sex, I need some wet shit, yeah, I need some bacon, yeah.
I'm gonna show you guys how to make cinnamon French toast sticks. So I start off with 1/2 cup of white sugar, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, mix that together, set it to the side. In a fresh bowl, crack in 2 eggs, 1/4 teaspoon of vanilla, 2 teaspoons brown sugar, 1 teaspoon cinnamon, and 1/2 cup of milk. Whisk that all together, then get out your Texas toast, cut off the ends, and then cut them into 3s. They should look like this, then dip them into your mixture lightly, add a tablespoon of butter to your hot pan, add in all of your cinnamon sticks, flip after 5 minutes, then throw into your brown sugar mixture. Serve with syrup and you're all done.
I'm making homemade birria quesa tacos. I've been seeing a very Americanized version all over the internet, so today I'll be showing you guys how to make it the authentic way. Need about 6 chile guajillos, 3 chile de árbol, and about 5 ancho chiles. You want to add those to a big pot of water with 5 pounds of chuck roast, everything that I have listed on the screen as well. You want to skim the top of your broth, we want it very clean. Add a hefty pinch of salt, cover and let it cook for about 1 hour. After 1 hour, you want to take out your chiles and add them to a blender. You also want to add in some of your onions, garlic, and cinnamon stick, as well as a little bit of our beef broth. You also want to add in everything that I have displayed on the screen. You want to blend until very smooth for about 1 to 2 minutes. We're going to add that to our beef broth. Also adding in 2 boiled tomatoes that I pureed. You want to let that cook for another 2 hours. Take your meat out of your broth and strain your liquid. You want to take your corn tortillas and dip them to your strained broth. Put them into a hot pan with some butter and you want them to get nice and crispy. Add your Oaxaca cheese, your shredded beef, some onions and cilantro. Dip them into your consomme with some onions and cilantro and you're done.
Every guy thinks that every girl's dream is to find the perfect guy. No. Every girl's dream is to eat with...
Yay!
Yay! Wipe it down.
Do you know how fucking hard it is to keep a healthy diet when your sister is constantly cooking and 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 cooking? I swear to God, I will hire her as my private chef when I get married.
All right, ladies, this is important. So if you're not a lady, go ahead and swipe on. Look, if your man doesn't cook for you, and I mean really throw down in the kitchen, not frozen pizza or ramen noodles, look, I'm not going to tell you to leave him because that's your business, like Tabitha say, but at least send him my page so I can put him on game.
Your churro mix till you hit to the top. Tickle, tickle. Just make it flat. Make sure you leave space in between so they don't stick together. Pop in the freezer for 15 minutes.
It's hard. Knock, knock.
Pop them out.
Churro cups.
Fry them in oil.
Oh, it's like a boat.
Base that baby up. Turn it around. You that 2C slide. Once golden brown, sprinkle cinnamon sugar. Put on a rack. Chocolate ice cream. Strawberries. Powdered sugar. And time to eat.
So a big request I've got a lot lately is for me to mix a bunch of random things into ice cream, but I'm not one to just make ice cream to waste, so I had to wait for an order. Well, today we got one. We were open, so we had to do it fast. So if you can tell, I'm kind of frantic and the camera's going everywhere, but it's because I had all these toppings to add to this ice cream and I had to do it before somebody walked in. So I had my coworker Maddie on lookout for the door, and she was also reading me all however many toppings there are in this. I'm not sure if you know how Colson works yet, but you get one topping for free and everything after that is extra. So usually at most, people only get like three. But for some reason, when people order online, they get crazy and order like 15 toppings.
Candy flavored ice cream. In a large bowl, add 2 cups of heavy whipping cream. Whisk until it forms stiff peaks. And by now, you know how we test this. Nothing comes out. It's good. Fold in 1 14-ounce can of sweetened condensed milk. Add 2 tablespoons of sugar and 1/2 teaspoon of cotton candy flavoring. Fold in. Now divide it into 2 different bowls. Add blue food coloring to one. And fold. And pink to this one. Now fill a freezer-safe dish, a little bit at a time, different colors. A little bit of blue, and keep alternating. Tap it down, cover with plastic wrap, freeze 4 to 6 hours. When your ice cream's frozen, pull it out of the freezer.
Scoop it out.
Now for the taste test, with what else? Our tiny spoon, of course.
If you love tacos, you have to make this. I'm not even kidding. It's the best thing we've ever eaten in our lives. So you brown some beef in a pot. You add some beef stock, some bone broth, and some water to that. And then to that, you add a whole onion, a whole thing of garlic. You add some chili, some carrots, a bunch of bay leaves, and some thyme as well. And you let that cook for an hour until all the veggies are like all soft and mushy. And then you take all the veggies out and put them into a blender. And listen, the real Mexican recipe has a bunch of dried chilies as well. You can't get this in Australia, so I just added chili flakes. And then you add some tomatoes. You add some more bay leaves, some cumin powder, some cloves, and then you mix that all up. And I also added some smoked paprika powder. I don't know why. I think I did for color. Who cares? Anyways. And then you sift that sauce back into the pot to get out all the chunky bits, and you let it cook in that for 3 hours. And I also topped it up with water like every 40 minutes to keep it like wet. But look how nice it pulls apart after 3 hours. And then you dip the tortilla in the sauce, you put some meat on there, you put some sauce and some cheese on there, and also some onion and coriander. You fold it up, and oh my goodness, you're welcome. It's so good. I love it.
What's up, everybody? I hope you guys are all having the most awesome day ever. I know I am. Here is a delicious sweets platter that I made yesterday that consists of different types of cakes and cookies, which were absolutely delicious. Tonight, I'm going to be watching one of my favorite movies on the app Likewise. If you don't know what Likewise is, it's an app that helps you get personalized TV shows and movie recommendations. You can also get awesome suggestions for podcasts and books as well. I highly recommend getting this app, especially if you are bored one night out with your friends and don't know what you guys want to do. You can watch a great movie on the app Likewise. And if you ever get bored, might as well try it out. To download the app Likewise, click the link in my bio. The best part is that the app is free to download. Thank you guys so much for all the support, and I hope you guys all have the best rest of your day. Bye!
Hey everyone, it's Ariana, and I just realized my culinary idol, Chef Gordon Ramsay, followed me on
Ariana,
TikTok.
Do you know what you're doing now?
Yes, Chef!
Let's go.
Yes, Chef!
When I was 12 years old, I had the life-changing opportunity to learn from Chef Ramsay on season 6 of MasterChef Junior, and to celebrate this very exciting moment, I decided to recreate his notoriously difficult signature dish, the Beef Wellington. Chef Ramsay, if you're watching this, it would mean the world to me if you reacted to this video and let me know how I did. Step 1 is to season a filet mignon steak with salt and pepper and then sear it in the pan, which is the first layer of flavor. Then you make the mushroom duxelle, which is basically blended up mushrooms that you saute to get rid of all the water. To start assembling the Wellington, we add a layer of Parma ham on top of a sheet of plastic wrap, then we add the duxelle, and then the steak using the plastic to wrap it tightly and refrigerate for 20 minutes. Then I brushed the layer of puff pastry with egg wash to help it stick, wrapped the beef Wellington in the puff pastry, and then scored it and sprinkled it with a little bit of sea salt. The welly bakes at 200 degrees Celsius for about 25 minutes and then rest for 10. Finish with the red wine reduction sauce. And Chef, I hope I made you proud.
Nutella hot chocolate.
Oh, baby.
Combine about 2 cups of milk, a nice big spoonful of Nutella,
a pinch of unsweetened cocoa powder,
a pinch of sugar,
a little salt,
vanilla extract,
and a splash of heavy cream.
Stir this up over medium heat until well combined.
Pour your hot chocolate into a blender,
then blend at the highest speed.
Coat the lid of your mug in Nutella,
pour in your hot chocolate,
add a homemade marshmallow,
and give it a quick torch,
then finish with some crushed candy cane.
Hot chocolate just doesn't get better than this.
All right, we're making apple nachos, aka the best healthy snack ever. These are the best apples, change my mind.
Cut them into thin slices like this, and then you're gonna plate them super extra, but this part is crucial because it gets coating on every single apple slice. Then I'm adding some natural peanut butter. I like using natural peanut butter because it's a lot more runny and it's obviously cleaner ingredients than regular peanut butter, so I always use that. And then I use pumpkin flaxseed granola from Costco, and I sprinkle that all over. And then I add some cinnamon and put that all over as well. And you can get creative with this stuff. You can add some cacao nibs, some sea salt, whatever. I'm putting some honey on in this clip. And that is it. It's literally so easy. It's the best snack ever. And it's so pretty. And I just love it. I hope you try it. Okay, bye. Every guy thinks that every girl's dream is to find the perfect guy. No. Every girl's dream is to eat without getting fat. Duh.
Yesterday, I documented what my normal day at Cold Stone looks like, which is making a lot of ice cream. And many of you are questioning why I look so pale. Well, the color actually sets once the ice cream freezes. So this is what it looks like when it comes out, and then this is what it looks like when we scoop it out of the kid. Which one do you think has the biggest transformation? You guys also taught me from that last video, there's a lot of people that hate my ice cream out there. Which one's your favorite? You also all wanted to know what our popular flavors are. It's sweet cream, chocolate, cake batter, coffee, in that order.
Takeout reviews part 20, Milk Bar. Milk Bar is one of my favorite bakeries in New York. My birthday cake is always from Milk Bar. We got the birthday truffles, the birthday cake, the strawberry shortcake, and a birthday cake milkshake. The birthday cake is iconic, and I definitely have to throw an honorable mention out to their crack pie. If you're in New York, you have to stop by.
Okay.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
You have to make this breakfast burrito. Sprinkle cheese, eggs, crispy bacon, avocado, drizzle some hot sauce in there, fold in the sides, roll that bad boy up, toss it on a pan till you get that nice grill mark, flip it back over, cut it in half, toss it on a plate, and enjoy.
This Cajun chicken pasta is one of my favorite recipes to make. It's creamy, cheesy, and spicy, just the way I like it. Marinate the chicken with all the spices on the screen for at least half an hour. Shallow fry both sides until it's well done. Just look at that chicken. Now in the same pan, add in some crushed garlic and red chili. Saute them for a minute or two. Add in one chopped onion, let it cook together. To this, add in tomato paste and chili paste. Give it a good mix and add in one diced tomato and yellow bell pepper. Add in 1 cup cream and 1 cup pasta water with chicken stock cube. Once it starts simmering, add in rest of your spices. To this, add in dried parsley, chili flakes and grated parmesan. I also added a blend of mozzarella and cheddar to make it more cheesy. Then some salt to taste, and finally you can add in your cooked pasta. Combine it well with the sauce. This is starting to look really good. Now you can plate it. It smells amazing and you won't be disappointed with this recipe. It's so flavorful. Top it off with the cooked chicken and enjoy.
Guys, I'm not even sure what to call this today, but yay. I'm going to show you how to make this really delicious breakfast roll. First thing I'm doing is just taking a Pillsbury pizza crust and stretching that out on my cookie sheet. Then I'm going to put a layer of shredded cheddar cheese, then cut strips out of your dough on the side. Now I'm putting a layer of just some basic scrambled eggs. Then I'm going to lay on some sausage I cooked up. After that, I'm going to put some bacon. I had a lot of stuff I needed to use up today. So after you got that in there, you're just going to cross it over like this. It started so promising, and then I don't know what I did. It wasn't so pretty, but that's okay. Doesn't matter. Now we're going to brush this with some melted butter and bake it in the oven at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 12 minutes. It really doesn't take that long. And here we go.
Wait, let me introduce you to the Gooby Blue Raspberry container. I added a layer of chamoy at the bottom of the container. Then I took a blue raspberry bear and wrapped it inside a blue raspberry sour belt. I then added some sour smurfs to the side of the container, along with some blue raspberry bears. Once I was done adding the bears to the side of the container, I did add some blue raspberry sour punch straws. And I finally topped it off with some blue raspberry sour pelts. I think I said blue raspberry a million times in this video. This container is available on my website, and every single one is crafted with so much love.
So I decided to make the pasta, the Gigi Hadid one everyone's been talking about on TikTok. You're going to add some olive oil to a pan and put some onion in that, let that simmer. Then you're going to add in some garlic, let that simmer. A tablespoon of tomato paste, mix that up. You want to keep mixing. Half a cup of heavy cream. Keep mixing it up until it looks like that. Some salt, black pepper, smoked paprika, chili flakes, a little more chili flakes, garlic powder, then a tablespoon of butter, Parmesan cheese, mix it up with some pasta water, and it looks like that, final product.
Enjoy.
Have you ever seen ice cream this stretchy? It's called Booza, and this is how it's made at the Republic of Booza in Brooklyn. Booza is smoother, denser, and creamier than typical ice cream. It's made using a 500-year-old technique originally developed in the Eastern Mediterranean. The stretchy consistency comes from two main ingredients. They're whisked with milk, cream, and sugar and added to a freezer drum. The mixture is then pounded with a 3-foot-long wooden pestle. This activates the ingredients and works out all the air. Then it's stretched by hand. At Republic of Booza, you'll find over 10 flavors.